Hi, everyone, and welcome to another Level Up Short. Today, I'm excited to talk to you about analytics. So let's hop on in, and I just want to start with a high-level view of this and why you should really care about analytics and why it's so powerful for improving your game. So there's a few really important reasons why you want to use analytics. Starting off, most obviously, analytics are a great way to measure game and feature performance. So it's one thing to hop into your game and get qualitative data from seeing players actually play your game. And it's another to get a nice high-level view and some quantitative data of what all of your players are doing in the game in order to make important decisions on how to make your game better. As I was just mentioning briefly, analytics provides a great high-level view of your overall game's health. So we're going to hop into some specific metrics in a minute here. But for example, when you see that your day one retention is lower than a benchmark, that's a good indication, for example, that you need to improve your onboarding experience for your players, right? So there's a lot of really good applications for different metrics that you can use in order to improve the performance of your game. Analytics are also great for surfacing game and feature optimizations. Maybe your metrics aren't too low, but you notice that there are some improvements that could be made, right? This is going to point you to different directions of your game that you need to fine tune in order to squeak out a few more numbers there and make your game a little bit better, right? So there's a whole rabbit hole that we could go down on analytics for today. I just want to talk about the highest level of analytics that you can use. And in my opinion, everyone should be using in order to take a look at the health of their game, identify areas of improvement, and to optimize their game. We call these key performance indicators or KPIs. And there's three high level ones that I would identify that we use. These are engagement metrics, retention metrics, and monetization metrics. So we're going to break down each of these one by one and what some of the specific ones are underneath each of these categories, as well as some of the applications of them. First, we have engagement metrics. So there's a few that fall under this category. They are daily active users, or we call this DAU. These are the number of users that are in your game for a given day. Similarly, we have monthly active users. These are the unique number of users that are in your game over the course of a given month. And then finally, we have average session length. So to break these down further and what each of them mean and how you can apply them as a designer, first, we have our daily active users. So this is a great way to understand the overall health of your game over time, right? Maybe at the peak of your game, you're at 1 million players, and a few months later, you're seeing that it's trending down to 800,000, 500,000, 1,000, right? Depending on the scope of your game. That's a good indication that, okay, maybe something in my game isn't healthy because I'm not continuing to retain my players, right? So when you see that there's a downtrend in this number here, you could take a look at other numbers in order to determine and troubleshoot what the issues are with your game. Similarly, monthly active users provides a high level overview of how players are performing month over month, right? So some months just naturally are going to be more popular than others. Think about like October with Halloween. Think about December with the holidays, right? Just some are naturally going to be better than others, but you can use this to compare those months one year after another, right? So let's say last year you had 50,000 users in your game, and let's say this year you only have 30,000, right? That's an indication of how your game is trending, and that's something that you can react to. Third, we have our average session length. So this is for an individual user or the average of your users, how much time they're actually playing your game from the start of their session, that is logging into your game, to the time that they log out of your game. So this has a few applications. One of the most important ones for me as an economy designer is understanding just how much time my players are actually playing my game, so I can tune my features in order to be the proper balance that both challenges the player, but is achievable within the time that they're willing to spend in my game. Similarly to the other ones, this is also a health metric. So let's say you add some major feature update to your game and suddenly you see that this number is lower, or conversely and more positively, maybe that number is higher, right? That indicates the overall success of both that feature and the way that your game is trending. Okay, so those are our engagement metrics. Up next, and arguably, in my opinion, as a designer, the most important set of metrics, we have retention. So retention are metrics that determine whether or not our players are returning to the game. And they're measured over different periods of time. So day one retention is from the first time that they play the game. This is on day zero to the second day, which is D1. Are they returning to the game? Our next one is our day seven retention, or similarly our week one retention. And this is asking a similar question of, for a new player who just joined our game last week, did they return the following week? And then finally, you're getting the trend here by day 30 or month one retention for a player who started last month, are they returning to the game this month as well? So these three sets of metrics tell me different things as a designer. For my day one retention, if I see that these numbers are low, that indicates that players are joining my game on the first day, and there's some issue there that is not motivating them to want to come back the next day. Typically, most commonly, this is that the player is getting confused or frustrated with the experience, or maybe you're just spending too much time trying to tell them how to play and they're not actually getting to the moment where they find fun with the game, right? So regardless of what it is in those set of issues I've identified, typically if I see a low D1 retention, the first place that I'm looking to is my onboarding and my first time experience for my players. Next, we have our day seven or week one retention. And this metric indicates whether or not my progression systems are working in my game. So we've talked about on Level Up before your short, medium, and long-term goals for the game. Day seven retention is a good indication of my midterm goals for the game. Am I thinking about, as a player, what I'm achieving next week? And if a player is not able to identify that, chances are they're not going to return to your game. So taking a look at your day seven and week one retention is a good indication of the success of your progression systems in your game. Next up, we have our day 30 retention or month one retention. And this is for the long-term goals in the game. When a player has really started to master my game or reach the end game of my game, is there things there that keep their attention? Are there social experiences that compel them to come back and friendships that they've made? Are there challenges that I'm presenting to that player who's high level that continues to challenge them and that they want to continue to accomplish or accomplish more efficiently over time, right? So if I see issues with my day 30 retention, that's typically where I'm looking. Okay, so those are retention metrics, our last set of metrics and arguably most popular with any developer you're gonna talk to, are your monetization metrics. These are the metrics that indicate how well the game is performing from a business standpoint. So the three high level ones, and there are others that I would take a look at as a designer, are our average revenue per daily active user for every player in the game, even those who don't spend, what is the average amount that they spend? So that's basically what that one is saying. Our conversion rate, which is arguably the most important monetization metric, this is taking a look at what percent of all users have actually converted in your game or spent any amount of money at all in your game. And then finally, you have your average revenue per paying user, which is for all users who have ever spent in your game, what is the average amount that they have spent in the game? So we'll break down each of these as well. First one, your average revenue per daily active user, similar to our engagement metrics that we looked at before on a monetization standpoint. This is a good snapshot of the overall health of the game because it encompasses both the conversion rate or those who have been motivated to spend as well as those who have spent before. So this is taking a look at overall, are there successful systems in my game that motivate players to want to spend? So if I see issues with these, typically this is the highest level one that I want to take a look at. And then I'm going to dive into the next two that I'm about to talk about here. Our next one is conversion rate. So this is for all users in the game, what percentage of them have actually spent before? The reason why I say this is the most important monetization metric is because a player who spends any amount in your game is much more likely again in the future to spend in your game, right? So if you see that your conversion rate is lower than your benchmark for your competitors, typically you want to take a look at what offerings you have in the game for players to actually spend on, and are they actually compelling? Are they actually worth it? do they make players feel good or feel powerful or feel rewarded for actually spending to get them? And if the answer is no, that's your problem, and that's why players aren't spending on anything in your game. The third monetization metric is your average revenue per paying user. And what this tells me is what we call spend depth. So for users who spend in your game, are they motivated to spend a lot or a little or somewhere in between, right? And typically, if you see a low number for your average revenue per paying user, the common scenario that you're going to see there is that somebody spent on your game and either one of two scenarios happened. First, they either spent and it was way too good and they're no longer required to actually spend again or motivated to spend again. So in the most extreme example here, let's say that you have a game pass that gives infinite money, right? I would typically attribute that to a low average revenue per paying user, right? Because once they get infinite money, why do they need to spend again? They already have everything that they want. The second scenario is that they spent and they discovered that it wasn't worth it, or it wasn't rewarding, or it didn't feel good to do. So they don't want to spend again. They feel like they were cheating, right? So typically, if your average revenue per paying user is low, it's one of those two categories. It's either too good or not so good, not somewhere in between. So that's all I have for my KPIs and analytics for today. Please stay tuned to Level Up in the future. We have so many more analytics to go through, so many more strategies for these to go through. And if you find these videos helpful, please comment, please like, please subscribe, and look forward to more content in the future.